this is a pretty wet place. And, you know, we had come up with land tours, but we didn't have water tours. And he wrote a water tour. There's a whole lot of history out there. And the schooner will be used as the vessel for taking people on the tour. And since it's a sailboat, it's a bit slower than a power craft, so it ought to soak up about enough time by the time you get back. Everybody will have had a good time and we'll have had enough. Any questions? Yes, sir.
Is the water going to be fixed?
No, you can't tilt the rudder. We're going to have to be careful about where we sail it. The draft of the boat is less than 4 feet with the board up. And so the skeg and the rudder protect each other, but still, you know, the rudder doesn't kick up. This rudder is huge. It's 9 feet long and about this tall. It's a big old barn door affair. It has to be to work in that shallow environment.
Is it balanced?
Sorry?
Is it balanced?
It is balanced.
We've got some falling.
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah, it is balanced. It's a balanced river. Yes, sir.
No auxiliary slip pipe?
Sorry?
No auxiliary engine?
Well, yes. Yeah. It will be an inward engine. Yeah. We're not done.
What do I have to apply that?
I mean, these existed before the days of imports, but all the harbors were set up for sailboats. And they are not set up for sailboats. Yes, it will be powered.
What's your estimate of the time when you finish it?
That's not a fair question. If we have raised enough money now to get all the way through phase 3 and into phase 4 of the construction, which will take us to the point where it's decked, the masts are not built, and the sails are not built. And I think we can get to that point in a year from here. Yes, sir.
You left out a little bit of a story about bringing it back to Vandenberg.
About what?
Bringing it back to Vandenberg.
I left out a lot of the story about bringing it back to Vandenberg. I guess the best part about it is we got it back. We showed up in Vandenberg, and we had to unload that hangar. You saw the news. There was a lot of stuff in there besides the boat. And the local navigation district loaned us a forklift. They said, no problem. We put it in there. We can get it out. Well, they couldn't. There's no way they could get this thing out. So Ken Curley, this gentleman here, who is a genius, went up there, and between the several of us, we finally worked it out. This one forklift wasn't going to do it. We were shocked. It was about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. It gets hot in Amarillo, Texas. We're inside this hangar. It's called, man, it's miserable. And we're looking at this huge old boat. This is the last chance. It's going to work or it didn't. So we took a break. We went and we had some Texas barbecue. And that cured it. That did it. Eat that Texas barbecue gave us all that we needed to go back and solve the problem. And what we did is we borrowed a huge forklift from the guy who was gawking. Anybody have a big forklift? He said, I got a huge forklift. So we brought it in and bingo. We put it on the truck. Is that the part of the animal that you were? Yeah, we were not. It was not a fun trip until that point. Okay. Yes?
The model that up the Scouts Corner, is that in the museum?
The one in the museum is the one that we built. It's over at the Maritime Museum. The plans up on the wall are indeed those of the Scouts Corner that we're building. And Howard Chappelle drafted those plans. He was a big number in boats. He was at the Smithsonian Institution for 30 years, and he drafted American Sailing Craft. He wrote 3 books about it, and he documented the history of all these local sailing craft that now would be forgotten if not for his work. So he drafted those plans, but somebody in Galveston, actually at Smith Point, took the lines off the boat. That means they measured it and put it all down in order so that the plans could be. And this boat was a very fine-lined boat, obviously pretty fast. And Chappelle thought, might have been smuggler. I don't know what they were smuggling. What did people smuggle back then? Who knows? So that's where the lines came from. So the boat started life at probably Puerto Blanco, we're not sure. And then ended its life on a mud bank out of Smith Point in sometime in the just before World War II. It lived a long time. Yes, sir.
When the project finished, what did you estimate the whole cost to be?
Well, the cost of the materials to get it through to the point of mast is $24,000. Only what we spent on it, so we can get it decked and ready to build the mast for $24,000.
What was the age or the length of working time for one of these?
But just depending, you get an order and you go around, it's all over. Yeah. But 30, 40 years was a long time for a railroad. Kind of like shrimp. They really work hard, those shrimp boats. They drop those, they don't anymore, it's hardly they left. But they drag these trawl doors behind, and they're always straining, the boat's always under terrible load. So these work boats have a short life, generally speaking. They were built out of cypress and longleaf pine, the two best boat-building woods ever, and they grew in Texas. And everything was built out of them until after World War II, when apparently we overcut the supply in order to produce piggy boats and all kinds of things to win the war. Some odd things were done during the war to get through, and so we ran out of wood.
I've seen
them
tearing down some of the barracks.
This floor right back here in the original part of the community center is pecan. And apparently, reportedly, supposedly, it came from a barracks on pecan flooring. Not a bad deal.
Wartime. The government says that we needed to win the war. God.
We did it.
Thank you.